Welcome to Tornado Country Scenario for City Skylines. In the last part we were building the cities and building towards Big Town. Now, Big Town is a major milestone when it comes to building your cities. As you can see here, we unlock another tile, we unlock metros, which are going to be the key form of public transport I'll be using. Got lots of new policies. I'm not a big fan of some of these high tax policies. Key ones is we've now got high density residential, high density commercial and offices. We've got incinerators, which allows us to get rid of the landfill sites. We've got a prison, and of course we've got new buildings now. We've got the earthquake sensor, tall radio masts, fire watch, deep space radar, which is useful for detecting meters. So we're just going to let the city run. We're going to run on speed 2 now. So we've now got the city in this key point. What I want to do is, first thing I want to do is get a couple of incinerators in up here. And this is getting, I can't see how full that is. It's all gone a bit for some reason. But what I want to do is, probably this one would be the oldest one. I want to switch that to empty. Actually, let's put a second incinerator in. What I want to do is get rid of these. Not that I've got any aesthetic kind of dislike for them. It's just that I want the space. That's probably the polite way of saying it. And we've got this area here. Now, as I said, this big city delivers high density residential. Now, what you've got to be careful of now is not to zone in lots of stuff, because you can see the city is getting busy. We've only got the one road access, although we will be working on a new one up here. And the trick is not to go overboard. So you could go here, and I've seen people do this on Let's Plays. They will dezone a massive area like that and rezone it for high density just to get the city growing. And that is a recipe for causing massive amounts of traffic. What you need to do is try and keep this in the green. The city's growing. You've got to remember there's no time limit on this scenario. So what you want to do is keep, as long as you keep the city in the green and growing, you can just let it go. So it's gone negative because I've actually killed off a lot of people there. But, and the other thing I want to do also is we're going to start converting this to offices. The reason being is, if I come here, you can see there's a noise value here. See where it's spread into the city, and this eventually will become a highway. And noise affects people's health. I mean, I haven't checked the scenario goals. So far, we haven't had anyone who's actually lived their full lifespan in the city. So what we're going to do is we're going to use offices. The other advantage with offices is the fact that we will be using offices to offset the growth of industry, because at the moment I don't want my industry to sprawl too far, purely and simply because I want to be able to move it. Again, this industry will be moving. Now, if I click on here, if we turn this way, we will be expanding this way over time, but I don't think I'll be expanding in this part. I want to work on this city, get this transition, major transition go, get a bit of public transport in, and then we will expand this way over time. I mean, we will probably buy that tile eventually, but it's worth noting that this will be city 1, that you could call it, and this could be city 2, but I will not be putting any road links across this river. What we will be doing is using rail links to move cargo. I'm not a big fan of using railways to move people. We'll have some metros and some footbridges, maybe a tram link through as well, but not using roads. And the reason for that is that, see that you've got the two links here. If you connect this road, if I connected this road through to here, what would actually happen is you'd get lots of through traffic coming through the city. And then what that would actually cause is lots of traffic that doesn't actually benefit your own city. We've got a bit of a power problem here for some reason. Let's see, how's the power? Yeah, power's getting low. I think it's time for We need to put another power station in. Maybe it's time to. I think we'll put another power station over here. I want to spread the risk a little bit. So I think we'll put another power station over there. And the next area I want to kind of work on is down here. Actually, it's zoning in a little bit more high density. I think maybe we'll go for a double block here while I'm talking. That is. Yeah. And the advantage also, the other thing you want to bear in mind is that when you're putting in high density things, also we've got a bit of water issue here. Come down here. Oh, my grid has got a really, really messy. I think there's a water problem up here as well. Ah. Get you there. Don't know, that's one building. What was I saying? Yeah, when you're rezoning areas, have a quick look round to have a kind of check of your building layouts. Make sure that you've got like education, which is what we're going to be looking at. We've got universities, which we're going to be putting in a minute. We've got probably that's high, but you can see here there's a little bit of a distribution problem here. So I'm kind of going to do is take that out and move it over there. I mean, these ones would be unhappy, but we'll be using public transport to move people around. High school's getting a bit low, so I think maybe we've got a high school there, we've got a high school there. We don't have a high school down here. I think maybe we will put a high school in down here. And of course we've got a little bit of a area to zone in there. And the city's grown, but I want to get the university down here because I want to kind of make it look a little bit special. I'm kind of a bit inclined to put it into this area here. So it's quite a big building. I think maybe we're kind of come in here, come down. I don't really want it to connect to. I think we can kind of do something like that. What can we do is kind of put it like that. Pretty modern looking. I think we can live with that, and I think maybe we're put round it to make it kind of stand out as an area cut. Maybe leisure wise. Got here, basketball court. Yeah, but drop a basketball court in there. There. So you've got a kind of bit of a frontage. All the basketballs, because I mean, I have to accept that the city's going to have to be pretty dense, so we're gonna have to make some compromises on layout, but at the same time, I don't want it to look totally kind of unaesthetic, is probably the correct word I'm looking for. Again, we've got a bit more growth, I think maybe we're. Start putting in some high density over here as well. Kind of spread the load a bit. That might actually. How's the traffic coming in? It's not too bad. You can see it's piling up a little bit on this roundabout. I think maybe it's time to do the upgrade. And I think this is what you've got to do with the city. Is. So I think we're. Now. Sometimes the way you upgrade these roundabouts affects the way it actually the nodes. So it's quite strange actually. If you leave like there, see? Oh no, it's done it. Sometimes if you kind of do a bit and leave a bit in the middle, then it won't actually let you upgrade it. I've never really found out why it's done that. And I think we'll do this one as well. I mean, this one is not quite so important because this is about as far as go. We're not going to put any links through there, but I think it's partly aesthetic that's why I'm doing this. A little bit unhappy about here. Maybe we're going to put that in there, but I don't really want to open up this just yet. I think what we will try and do is crossroads, as you can see here, it can actually affect traffic. So what you can do is kind of come out like this. That's 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 there, and if you take this out of the center, what that might do is that might ease the flow a bit, because T junctions are often kind of a bit more efficient than crossroads. Now you can see there's got people crossing over, that's good. Yep, so as I say, I think this part is going to be growing the city, and I think I think maybe it's time to get some work on this area, and I don't think we actually need those power lines now. Power connection there, we've got a link there. Yeah, I don't think we need these power lines anymore. They can come out. We can just zone in across the whole area here. I think what we'll do is put a little bit of kind of what you could call minor offices along there, just to act as a small down break from there. Because again, the sound does affect the health of your residents. So we've got this running here. I think what we'll do also is we've got a bit of demand for commercial. I think what we're going to do is kind of actually just come in like that. Always doing that. Apologies, guys. I don't know, I seem to have a fixation for clicking on the one-way road. And I think what we can do here is, again, what I sometimes like to do is, if you imagine, well, let's do it. What I would do is I would put a line of 4 offices like that, and we'll go light commercial for 4, because light commercial produces less noise, and then we'll go heavy commercial for the rest, and then that would give a noise gradient for that area there. I think maybe we'll get a little bit of offices on this corner here, and maybe a little bit of offices there. Actually, don't take that away, not a bit too close. And of course, eventually we'll have offices all the way down here. City's still growing. We've got nearly 9,000. It's growing really, really nicely. I'm really happy with this. And maybe we'll push the boat out a little bit and we'll go here. And what I want to do is, I don't really want to start expanding the city until I've got this high density. And the way to imagine it is, this is going to be the core of my city. And then we'll have another city there. And what we'll also do is eventually we'll buy the tiles. Facility full, yep. So I think we're going to need to drop another garbage in here. I'm not going to empty this one till this one's empty, because otherwise you'll overload your garbage collection. So that's something to remember. Oh, we've got a water problem down here. And I think when the city's growing quickly, this is what you've got to concentrate on. Avoid the temptation to start wholesale expansion. I know from a YouTube point of view, it's not the most exciting thing to watch. And I think that kind of brings me on to a key point, that this will probably be the last kind of direct follow-on part from the city. Trashed there again because the facility's full, but sometimes you just gotta let the trucks get in there. Don't panic. Yeah. So from now on, I will do a part, kind of show you guys interesting elements that have gone. I'm just gonna check the water, okay. but and then I will do a certain amount of the routine stuff, a bit like what I'm doing now off camera. But I really wanted to show you guys how to grow the city so you don't lose control of the traffic. And see here how balanced the traffic is. I think what we can do is upgrade this area here. I think that will help kind of ease that flow off. But again, you could upgrade these, but what you can do is if you upgrade these, you will suck more traffic into this area. By keeping these narrow, especially if there's no queue on the highway, you can actually improve the filtering here. You can see the residents coming in here actually. I'm going to click on here and if we can pick up them. We'll just follow someone for a little while. See the way the truck's here. Well, this is actually a new person with their pickup truck. They've come into the city and they're coming in here. Obviously we're going to have to do some work with this area here. And so sometimes it just pays to just follow the traffic. See where it's going. I know there's traffic managers mods and I have used them, but I don't want to use it in this scenario. But hopefully, because there's a lot of people crossing here, I think what we might do is put a footbridge in here. And you can see that they're coming in here, and this is there, and they've just got to their new house because this is the area that's going. I think what I want to do is repeat what I did on the other side here. This side is not quite so important as the road by the industrial, because this area here, and if you want to kind of encourage people to walk, what you can do is do something like this. Put a footpath. In fact, what you can do is do this. Do that. What you see is you kind of create a plaza here, and then people will walk. People still quite perversely will follow the footpaths, but they will walk across here, and then what you won't get them is walking round the roundabout. So you can kind of create a little plaza of footpaths like that, and you can see how many people travel through there, and that will keep the traffic flowing. I'd hate this here. I wish there was some way you could impose parking controls on traffic. Now, because we've built this area here, as you can see, this is empty now, so I think we can get rid of the landfill site. And of course, what we're going to do now is set this one to emptying. And again, we've got a little bit of residential demand growing, so I think it's time to get this in here. And I think we're de-render that. Get something in there just to keep the city growing. And now it's time, we've got to think about public transport. Don't have a lot of money, that's the main concern. So I think, and to be honest, I'm not a big fan of buses, not in large cities. I don't mind using buses when it's a small route. If we had a little village out here, I'd put a bus in. What I do really like is metros, but I think I really need to build up the reserves here. These are 15,000 a pop. I think what I can do is put in a kind of a starter metro in. So I think what we'll do is we'll put a metro there. And again, a lot of people put metro stations really, really close together. And it's not necessary, believe it or not. You don't really need to put metro stations. And I think what we'll do is we'll put a metro there. If you hear a chirping noise, that comes through on the video, is my smoke detector is telling me I've got a low battery. For some reason it does it every so often early in the morning. And I think we're just going to run that. We've got a bit of cash to play with. I've intentionally left it this way. I think maybe we can run Maybe we can get another couple of stations down here. And maybe we'll drop us one about there. And we're kind of. And I'm aware that I've really blown my cash, and that's a risk because I could end up. We had a disaster now, we could be in trouble because if we got hit by a tornado now, this scenario could be over. And I think what we'll do is just get this in here. But I think this is quite important. You need to get people using the public transport, because that is the way to ease your traffic. But you've got to give them somewhere to go. Just don't shove it down in an arbitrary way. And I think we can. I think we'll change that. We'll make that one red. Make this one yellow. No, actually, make this one kind of whitish colour. White stands up against the black. And what that should do is that will start to get people, like students, coming down to the university. That's why I deliberately put one here. You can see straight away we're up to 125 people. This metro station right outside something, a key building like a university, is a very, very good way to get your people moving around the city. You can see here your residents will use these, and I can guarantee it. And a bit more demand for commercial, and we're just gonna have to let the cash build up. So where I'm not sure how long this video has been running, actually, to be honest. I've done it again. Yep, I know I've got new land to purchase, but not interested just at the moment, I'm afraid. And I think we off here, coming through there, got a little, actually I can make that into a little square again, I think. I did up there, so you can do the same with pathways here. You get little squares like this, you can fill them in like that. Let's just check the power situation. Pause the game while I run power cables up round here. Do I really need power cables up to there? I actually don't really need them anymore, do I? I think what we could do is just run that there. Take out all this here. I think we can let the game run now because these power cables don't actually link into anything anymore as such. And what we could do, just as insurance, into there. What we can do is drop some, again, same principles before. Bit worried about this water, actually. I was watching it for a little while, and it does surge over this bank, up on this bank from time to time. So, got this here, a little bit of offices. Again, zoning some more high density. I'll do two blocks this time here. That's running in there quite very, very nicely. Maybe we're road out here. Again, this is really quiet. I mean, do I really need this one-way road out here? I think maybe we could take that off, actually. And I think maybe we can make this into a one-way type. Something like that. Because, as I say, we're not going to build anything excessively up here. So, and again, we can put some high density in here. Me? No, I think we'll reserve that for officers. I want to check something because I think I might have forgotten. I put a. No, I haven't put an earthquake sensor down. I'm really meant to do that in this part, guys, because this will detect sinkholes. So that means now that when. Oh, small city. Run to a small city. See, here you don't need to rush the growth. The city will grow. We've now got trains, hydropower, although I can't see us using hydropower in this city. I mean, this is not a major. As you can see here, this is the one I would really like, crematoriums and water treatment. That will change the dimensions of the city. You can see here the residential's dropped a bit now. We've got to 11,000. Got a little, quite a nice little wodge of traffic here. We've got a little bit of demand here, so I think what we can do is we can maybe put some, actually no, let's put commercial here. A little bit of commercial there, maybe a bit up here actually, zone this, and of course the map's slowed down a bit. Oops, I don't want to go that fast. Just go two times. Yeah, I'm sorry that I'm not doing anything really major at the moment, but I don't feel the need. I mean, I'd like to get another road junction out here. I think maybe that might be something we can do now, just to round this part off. As I say, I'm a bit not sure how long I've been recording. I think what we'll do is we'll put a new connection here, which I think is going to be quite important to draw some of this traffic away from here. The city's flowing quite nicely. If I kind of show it, we've got the metro running around in a loop here. We'll probably create another loop here, and what I will probably be doing is using trams as a cross service this way. So imagine we'll have a loop up here of metro. In fact, what I probably might do is create a spur there and then loop down, like add to the loop as it goes on for later. And then what we will have is we'll have trams running across, providing the cross links. That's the way I'll be doing it. And because eventually this highway will become, this will be upgraded to come down to here, and I think we'll probably keep growing this as a commercial area, but at the same time I want to leave space for railways. But I think we're going to pause the game. I'm going to put in this external connection. It won't take long, guys. I'm going to take all this out. So we're going to drop a, we're going to use one of these. And I'm more interested in it being square than, yep, I think that will do, even though I clicked it accidentally. I'll put my hand up to that. That was me being a bit over enthusiastic. And I think we can, and I'm just gonna come like that. And what I am going to do, got quite a lot of cash, so what I'm going to do is take this highway over here, back to here, and we're going to just maybe I need to get straight here. I know it's going to look awful, guys, you can wince at me. But there is a method in my madness, because eventually when this becomes, eventually both of these will become clover leaves. I will own both these tiles up here, and I will move the highway north. So eventually this highway will probably curve up something like that to give me more space on the top of the city, which is the reason why I've done this. Because what it means is I can now add another layer of industry along the top here. Which isn't massively important, but it will mean that I can now add an incinerator up here. Actually, let's put it about there next to the power station, because you can see we've got a little bit of a problem here, and I want this to be able to flow down. Next thing, what I want to do again, the money's a bit low, so I think I'm going to leave it at the moment. Let the cash build up. We're just going to build the city. See, here we've got, again, sometimes this is caused by the fact you can see the garbage trucks coming out, and we've got getting a bit blocked off here. And if you actually see here, I say it's for some reason it's all squidged up, but what you can actually see is the reserves, because this is filling out or emptying out, it's actually kind of causing this problem. There's quite a big flow of traffic here. You can see there's a big bit amount of traffic flowing here. I definitely think we're going to need to get, oh, that's because I've probably got rid of this little one way here that I created. I think we're do that. I think maybe we put a second exit road there. Yep, I caused that traffic flow. That's my fault. But we will fix this. I think I'm going to pause the game actually to fix this, and I think then this will be the end of this part, guys. So let's come out here. Look, we're talking about having something about round that tree. We're going to put in a roundabout here. It can be a bit wonky, not important. So it's gonna, I like when I build these roundabouts, I like to build with the one-way roads. And what I will do straight away is upgrade like that. And then we will this come in like that and come out like that. That gives me a link there. Let's bring these one-way roads over. It's a bit, I think if I take off the snapping, I can actually compensate for that a little bit. So the road won't be totally dead straight, but who cares? And now get the snapping back on. And we're gonna freebase this. That goes without saying that that one's gonna give me a bit of a problem. And I think we can now link this through here. Like that. I think come down here and just connect that through there. Again, this will start to draw off the traffic from this area, and I think we can, oops, I've done that, should I? Gonna have to move down a little bit. That was a bit of another fail. And this area can come out here, and you can come up. That will give us a bit more growth area for our industry. And I think we'll zone that in straight away, and I can go full width here. Maybe we can come up here. Oops, that link there's a bit of a problem. Maybe we can come there, link that through there. And I think this is where I'm going to leave it, guys. I think maybe I've bored you long enough. The city's growing. I say we can get a bit more in here. Graveyards keep the city growing, got demand for commercial, again, I think what we'll probably do is take some commercial out this way and maybe grow a bit more commercial up here. Maybe we'll drop some commercial in there. Keep the city flowing. And you can see here, things are coming together nicely. I'm quite happy with this. I say I want to resist the temptation for urban sprawl. We've got water problems here. We can fix quite quickly. And I think come out. Just come right across the top of the map like that. Connect like that. And don't worry about that manky highway. We will do the adjustment over time. Yep, you can see the difference that having this extra connection now has had. It's kind of easing off the flow a little bit, taking the pressure off of this junction here. City's growing. And I think sometimes you've just got to stop and have a look round. Oh, lovely, great. It'd be nice to fill that with water, actually, but I'm not sure how you do it. We could put one of these excess water pumps in there, but I don't know whether that would actually make it flood. Well, maybe we'll investigate that. Again, we've got get some high density in here. I think maybe we can put some over here now. Kind of push the city on. Remember, you've got, yes, I know, I've got newly unlocked transport. And I think we can dezone this area, get in some offices here. Get the city flowing really, really nicely. Maybe we can put in a little bit of commercial up here. I don't want it on this road, but I think we can put commercial here. Now, actually, not quite that close. Little bit of commercial here, because that's residential. I don't want that. And you can see our number of people walking. People will walk in your city if you give them the opportunity, and that's the key factor. I think maybe I'm quite happy with that. And this is where I'm going to leave it, guys. I'm rambling, and I apologise for that, because I can get really wrapped up in the city. You can see here we've got, I think we can make that into a little bit of a office space there as well. Because this is a sound break. And just check the sound there. Yep, that's good. Once those offices goes in, that will, you can see the effect, the difference here. You can see how far that spread. We put offices there. And of course, metro stations are very nice, but they do create noise. Look at that lot there. Look at that. All those people coming in. Shows how busy the metros are and how effective they can be. And I'm rambling again. Sorry, guys. And this is definitely where I'm going to leave it. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Hope you found it interesting. About growing the city. The next part, as I say, I will be playing on. Next part, I think we will definitely be, I will buy the tile now just to prove it. We'll be working on growing the city out this way and creating a new city here, which will be kind of self-contained to begin with. So they're not going to share services. House of water, yep, getting low. That'd be the next job. But that'd be for the next part or off camera. So this is where I'm going to leave it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Hope you found it interesting. And until next time, whatever you do, enjoy your gaming.